side. We welcome you to our May 14th regular board meeting. You will see a few vacancies over here to my left, your right. I will announce that I believe Mrs. Marla Scott is on her way. Maybe it will, so you will see her coming here. Vice Chair Hank cannot leave us today, so as Mrs. Owen did. So we do expect Mrs. Marla Scott. I recall, I believe, at our last meeting, complaining about how cold it was. Well, I don't think we can complain today. It should be very cold today. It's a little warm. It was 93 in Rocky Mountain. I don't know what it was when we had it. It's been warm today. But I'm not complaining, because I felt a little bit warm this morning. We're excited tonight, because this is what our vote will be. And that's when we get to see all these young boys and girls walking to say and speaking their words. And we are just so excited for them to be here. But before that takes place, we have a few things that we need to do. There is a purpose sheet, I believe, that's floating around that you should have in your hand as your agenda. We hope to have one to try to find that. After everyone take a seat, I will declare the meeting
Color guard, hold.
8.3A, approval to submit global utility service district starting grant. 8.10B, approval of a lease agreement between Morgan Girls Club and Edgecombe County Public Schools. Again, 8.10B, approval of a lease agreement between Morgan Girls Club and Edgecombe County Public Schools. You can add those three, and then if you amend, you can move the following two items, 8.3B, 8.9B. Here are none. I need to hear a motion to approve the agenda as amended.
Madam Chair, I move that we approve the agenda as amended and deleted.
Has been moved and properly seconded that we approve the agenda as amended and has been added and deleted. Any other discussion on the motion? All in favor of the motion, let it be known by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. The motion is carried. Thank you very much. Item three on the agenda are recognitions. The first item is invoking of the code.
It is my pleasure to recognize the ECPS Employee Club for May. Third grade teacher Paige Parker is recognized for her hard work and dedication to the students, staff, and families of GW Clark Elementary School. As chair of the school's 3C committee of former, she has spent the last few months thoughtfully planning the dad-daughter dance. She led her committee through the planning process, ensuring many special memories were made for the students and their parents. On the day of the event, she made sure the gym was turned into a magical place for everyone. The event was a huge success, and without Ms. Parker, it would not have been as successful. Her positive attitude and work ethic are what makes her such a great asset to the Carver family. Congratulations to the May ECPS Employee of the Month, Paige Parker. The North Carolina Council of Teachers and Mathematics and the North Carolina Department of Public Instruction strive to recognize and reward secondary mathematics teachers who exemplify math teaching excellence by nurturing student enthusiasm through everyday classroom experiences. We are pleased to recognize Shirley Lloyd from W.A. Patillo Middle School as the recipient of this year's award. She will also be recognized at the North Carolina Council of Teachers and Mathematics State Conference later in Greensburg. Congratulations to Ms. Lloyd. Two ECPS students have been selected to attend prestigious Governor School of North Carolina. Participants have met high standards of achievement in academics or performing individual arts. Governor School is a 5.5-week summer residential school for gifted high school students. The program integrates academic disciplines, arts, and unique courses. We are proud to recognize Charisma Gaskin from Charter High School and Matthew Chassie from Southwest Edgecombe High School.
Chair, members of the board. My name is Dr. Fred S. Wood Jr. It's my pleasure to serve as the president of the W. Tiller High School National Alumni Association. Our alumni association was formed in 1981, and its purposes are to provide scholarship and educational assistance to worthy students and to worthy educational organizations. We currently give out scholarships in several categories. We give out the Walter A. Patillo Alumni Scholarship. We give out a secondary scholarship each year for a former faculty member of our high school, a former W. Patillo student. We award the Nathan J. Lewis Memorial Scholarship to the member of the grandchild, child, or great grandchild to a member of the association. And we award the James E. Wood Engineering Scholarship, an endowed scholarship by the Wood family to an individual attending college and majoring in the field of engineering. But specifically tonight, we talk about the incentive awards for the program. So growing up in East Tarver and Princeville communities, we were blessed with many role models. Therefore, we are delighted to offer an incentive award program where we present an award to a student in each ECPS elementary and middle school in the name of an early pioneer in leadership and community services for those communities. The award recognizes a student chosen by their school and using the guidelines of their school who exemplifies the characteristic traits and examples of that person in a developmentally appropriate way. This award is a framed certificate and a $50 cash award. Possibly somebody might be visiting McDonald's tonight. The honoree this year is Ms. Laura Shaw Shields, affectionately called Ms. Laura or Sis Laura. She was born in 1894 and lived most of her adult life at 603 East St. John Street in Tarver. An entrepreneur in the 40s, 50s, and 60s, when few women were entrepreneurs, especially black women, she owned her own sewing business. She designed and made clothes for her family and for men, women, and children in the total community. Designing and creating high school prom and Easter dresses for young women was a specialty and a special delight for her. We heard that while she was fitting the person for a dress or any attire, she always gave pearls of wisdom on how to report herself and other helpful advice. She was married to Reverend William E. Shields. They had one son. But after her husband's mother died, she and her husband raised his four sisters. Miss Laura was a believer of a close family. She was an active member of Eastern Star Baptist Church, serving as the church clerk for many years. She always had a vegetable garden and would share her vegetables with family and friends, plus pecans from her two huge pecan trees in her backyard. When young people came to town seeking employment and had no place to stay, Miss Laura housed them until they could secure funds to accommodate their new arrangement. Mrs. Laura Sharp Shields was a woman who truly possessed the characteristics of a community servant. Madam Chair, please join our scholarship chairperson, Mrs. Charlotte Craig, and Mrs. Laura Cherry, niece of the honoree, to present this award.
Dedicated service to families and communities of East Tarver. As presented A. Lucilla High School National Alumni Association Incorporated. President Fred Lewis, scholarship chairperson, Lewis Street. Family of Mrs. Marshall, please come up.
They are students who have demonstrated qualities of good character and behavior and have made extra efforts to achieve academic success. Teachers nominate students who may have completed a special community service project or demonstrated special acts of kindness, consideration, or courage. At this time, with the elementary Golden Key students from Bullitt, Carver, Coker-Wimberly, Princeville, Scotts, and Mark Millennium, please move to the aisle of the South Building to be lined up. So all the elementary students, please make your way to the side.
Ladies Stroud,
He regularly participates and shares his thinking to help his peers succeed in the classroom. He dignifies himself with his positive character traits towards his classmates and the adults in the school. Jalen Edwards Moy. Jalen exceeds expectations in academics, behavior, and character. She works incredibly hard and always pushes to ensure that she has full understanding of new material. In Zyniqua, Maryland, she constantly displays positive character traits and goes above and beyond to help her classmates. She is always the first to volunteer to help in the classroom and throughout the school. Congratulations to the Gold Key students from Croker Wimberly Elementary. Martin William Academy. Darcy Watson. Darcy demonstrates leadership in the classroom. She always has a positive attitude and consistently helps other students. Tyann Watson. He is always working to better himself and his peers. He never backs down from being challenged and is very supportive in conflict resolution among his classmates. Congratulations to the elementary students from Martin Millennium Academy. Lane Academy, Ms. Javonna Reynolds, principal intern. Our first student, Sanaya Marbera. She's a leader who takes the initiative to help both her peers and her teachers without being asked. She has a positive attitude in class and works hard to accomplish her goals. Kayla Whiteman. Kayla is a positive role model for her classmates and school. She consistently reminds her classmates of school expectations. She strives to do her best in all of her classes. Congratulations to the middle school students from Marvin Millennium Academy. Our next school is dedicated to the middle school. The assistant principal, Ms. Julie Simpson, is on the board. Our student is Orion Austin. He is a respectful student who is always eager to help his classmates and teachers. He has worked extremely hard this school year. Edward Ramirez Ventura. He is an outstanding student who works hard on his academics. He is friendly to his peers and always respectful to the school staff. He is a shining example of a material Dynasty Johnson. Dynasty is a college student academically and in peer relations. She tries her best to relate to all students in a respectful and friendly way. And Xavier Black. He's a role model for other students and is careful not to engage in negative peer relations. Congratulations to the Gold Key students from the school. Thank you. congratulations to the Goki students from West Edge Public. So one more round of applause for all the middle school Goki students.
Self-discipline.
She is helpful and kind while helping her classmates. Brenna Bryant. She is an outstanding leader in the school. She is motivated, respectful, and a delight to have in the classroom. Congratulations to the Chalmers High School Golkey Student.